Hi everyone, welcome to my garden. My name is Kirsty. I'm based in Johannesburg, South Africa. So today I thought we could put together a green smoothie pot. Super delicious, absolutely love it. So let's get cracking. So let's talk about our potting soil medium. I like to use half a bag of the bark kroll manure, 2 handfuls of Atlantic fruit and flower, 2 handfuls of the Talborn organic seedling mix, 2 scoops of the HydroCash water retaining gel. This is super helpful when you have pots. Pots tend to dry out quite quickly, and I personally have found that if I'm using the HydroCash, it stays kind of moist, and obviously the plants don't wilt as quickly. And then I also use peat moss. I use this entire brick. You put it in 5 liters of cold water. It swells up probably 4 or 5 times the size of this, and I use an entire brick. So first of all, let's create a well in the beginning, in the bottom of our pot. Let's add some kitchen waste. Today I have a turnip that is well past its prime, avocado that nobody ate in the fridge, some eggshell cartons or the cardboard from the eggs, and then some onion scraps and the middle of a cabbage. So I'm going to add that to the middle of my pot, give it a good squeeze, tuck it in there, add some potting mix to the top. Right, what should we put in the middle? I am thinking kale. What kind of great green smoothie would we have if we didn't have kale? So let's put kale in the middle of our pot. I'm going to just top it up. It's a bit low. Okay, kale is in the middle. Let's go for one of our biggest here, which is a strawberry. Strawberries in a smoothie is delicious. So let's do a strawberry. Quite a lot of soil here. Just going to remove a bit of it so it can fit into our pot. Okay. And strawberries like to hang over, so I'm just going to pop it like that. Isn't that pretty? So there's our strawberry. Let's fill it in a little bit. And then what is strawberry without mint? So I'm going to add the mint. Oh, actually, I'm going to keep the mint in this small pot. And the reason for that is that the roots of mint are rather invasive, and I don't want them to strangle the rest of my plants. So I'm going to keep the mint. I'm going to pop it over here next to the strawberry, but I'm going to keep it in its pot. Let's add some parsley. Parsley is always yummy in a smoothie. Fill that with some potting soil. So here are some beetroot seedlings. I'm not putting them into the green smoothie mix for the actual beetroot, but for the leaves. The leaves are great in a smoothie. Celery. Celery is so good for you. I'm going to tuck that in right next to the strawberries. Let's just fill it in. What else have we got? Ah, red Russian kale. Not only does it look beautiful when it grows, but it tastes so yummy. I want to put that at the back here. Last but not least would be our spinach. How do you have a green smoothie with no green spinach? So here we go. I'll put that next to the kale at the back. And let's make sure we fill in all our gaps and press it down firmly. We press it down to make sure that the roots have contact with the soil. They're all snug and warm and happy. Let's water these babies in. So I like to use NutriFeed. It's one of my favorite products. So it's 5 to 10 grams per liter of water. I have already put some into my watering can, so I'm just gonna give that a quick stir. And water our green smoothie pot. Water the leaves. I think that's enough. And last but not least, we need to mulch, and I haven't brought my leaves, so let me go get those. I've got my autumn leaves. So let's add some mulch. It's just to help with some evaporation, keep the plants snug and warm because it is winter time. And there we go, our green smoothie pot is done. Thank you for joining me. I hope you enjoy. I am so excited to harvest this pretty soon. Enjoy, guys. Thanks for tuning in. Take care.